This is one of my favourite photographs from the Apollo 17 mission. It was taken by Mission Commander Gene Cernan through the window of Lunar Module Challenger and shows Command Module America flying over the Taurus-Littrow Valley, one orbit before Challenger began its descent to the valley floor. Nearly 40 years later, the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter took a photo of Taurus-Littrow from a similar angle. It's a beautiful match, as are comparisons between photographs taken by the astronauts on the valley floor and 3D topographic data sent back by Japan's Kaguya satellite a few years ago. One of the tasks performed by the astronauts during the Apollo 17 mission was photography of the mountains that form the sides of Taurus-Littrow Valley. On the north side of the valley are North Massif and sculptured hills, separated by a gap known as Wessex Cleft. Since the mountains are several miles away, the astronauts were provided with a camera with a 500mm lens, in addition to the standard Apollo Hasselblads used on all the missions. Since a 500mm lens has a much narrower field of view than the 60mm lens on the standard Apollo Hasselblad, the camera was fitted with a sighting ring on the side to help the astronauts aim the camera. Here's a photo of Apollo 16 astronaut Charlie Duke training with the camera. You can see the sighting ring on the camera here. Let's have a look at Gene Cernan taking a sequence of photos of North Massif during the second EVA on Apollo 17.
Okay. They confirm your lens cover's off. The sensors are in.
Copy that.
Lens brushes.
I hope this is the right study.
It is. Hey, try F56 directly down sun, or up sun, at that sculptured hill there in the distance. See what I mean?
I get it.
Okay, Bob, what else do I need here? Let's see, 500, MAG-R, need MAG-R. Soon as you're through.
Yeah, I think we got enough of those in our team.
Dinner.
You got the maps?
Yep, got them.
Some of these won't overlap, Bob, because I'm hurrying.
Don't smear.
Don't hurry and smear them.
They're not smeared, but I just didn't overlap some of them. Okay, everyone agrees to that. Don't hurry and smear them. I'll get those others, Jack, tomorrow.
Did you notice that rather than holding the camera the usual way up, with the sighting ring on the side, Gene has turned it 90 degrees with the sighting ring now on top, and he is aiming along the top of the barrel of the 500mm lens. So what, you might say? Surely stuff like this is only of interest to Apollo geeks like me. Well, not quite. It would certainly be important to photoanalysts who wanted to do accurate measurements using the fiducials placed on the photos by the grid of crosshairs on the Riso plate. The Riso grid was manufactured to a tolerance of 0.002mm. It's totally pointless having reference points of that accuracy on the photos if you don't know how the camera itself distorts the image. So each camera and lens combination was very accurately calibrated before each mission. You can find details of this work in documents such as this. Since radial lens distortion is not necessarily symmetrical about the optical axis, you need to know which way the camera was being held when each photo was taken, which is not obvious with a square format camera such as the Hasselblad, which is why NASA camera technicians placed these orientation marks on the Riso plates. And these marks do indeed appear on the sides of Gene's 500mm photos of North Massif, giving photo analysts a reference point when applying the pre-flight calibration data. Of course, these orientation marks appear on the top and bottom of most Apollo photos because most were taken with the camera in its usual orientation mounted on the astronauts' chest brackets. So when a so-called photographic expert such as David Percy tries to tell you that these marks are evidence of some sort of fakery, you can just tell him what they really are. And when a deluded buffoon such as Expattaffy claims they are photoshopped whistleblower clues, you can just have a good laugh. We can all have another good laugh at Taffy's expense when I upload my video about the astronauts' communication antennas in the next couple of weeks. The video clip of Gene Cernan doing his 500mm photography of North Massif will make an appearance in that video too. Have a quick look again and see if you can work out why Gene's antenna seems to disappear when he turns round.
Okay. They confirm your lens cover's off. The sensors are in.
Copy that.
Lens brushes.
I hope this is the right setting.
It is.
As always, please leave your answer below. I'll put the links to the documents and sources used in this video in the description box.